Like it goes ding 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 diggy ding ding. Ding 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 diggy ding ding. Ding ding ding. That's the way theirs goes. Ours goes ding 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 diggy ding ding. Ding 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 diggy ding ding.
Well said, Vanilla Ice. Musical artists have been drawing inspiration from other artists for as long as we can remember. They say imitation is the highest form of flattery, but at what point does it become straight up stealing? Today, we're talking about seven artists accused of stealing songs right here on Listed. Let's kick things off with Ariana Grande. When Ari released Be All Right on her album Dangerous Woman, fans of EDM producer compared the track to his 2015 song Firefly. The producer even posted a tweet about the song that he later deleted, saying, "Yeah, I didn't produce that Ariana Grande track." Yikes, the shade is real. Here's what the producer's song Firefly sounds like. Now, listen to Ari's Be All Right. Do the tracks sound similar? I'll let you be the judge. Muramusa never took legal action against Ari over the song, though. Justin Bieber and Skrillex didn't get so lucky. They were slapped with a copyright infringement lawsuit over their song, Sorry. Casey Dinell, who goes by the stage name White Hinterland, alleged that they stole a riff from her 2014 track, Ring the Bell. So first, listen to Ring the Bell. Okay, so that obviously kind of sounds like the riff in Sorry, which goes like this. Luckily, never fear, Skrillex is here to explain. The singer tweeted, quote, "Sorry, but we didn't steal this," along with a video of exactly how he created the riff.
Get down four semitones, 1, 2, 3, 4.
It's more than just your body. Oh, is it too?
Now take this.
Oh.
Pitch it up 12 semitones.
Okay, so that's amazing, and it just might prove that Skrillex didn't draw any inspiration from the White Hinterland song. Ed Sheeran has collaborated with the Biebs, and he's also been slapped with a copyright lawsuit. He was recently sued over his hit, Photograph. Songwriters Martin Harrington and Thomas Leonard claimed Ed's song is very similar to a track called Amazing that they wrote back in 2010 for UK X Factor winner Matt Cardle. According to the lawsuit, quote, "The chorus section of Amazing and the infringing Photograph share 39 identical notes, meaning the notes are identical in pitch, rhythmic duration, and placement in the measure." Do you think these two songs sound the same? Well, first, listen to Amazing.
How did you find me? You came out of nowhere like me. It's kind of amazing how you found me.
Now, here's Photograph.
So you can keep me. Inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet.
We have to admit, the songs do sound kinda similar. However, we love Ed and we believe he'd never knowingly rip someone off. There hasn't been a ruling on this suit as of yet. Even Queen Beyonce has felt the wrath of a copyright infringement lawsuit. She was sued over her track, XO.
But it turned to that time, before time is run out. Baby, love me.
Ahmad Javon Lane sued Beyonce for $7 million, claiming she stole his music for her track XO after he apparently passed his song to one of her backup singers to listen to. Beyonce's attorney said in the court documents that there was no melodic content and there is no meaningful similarity in pitch, series, rhythm, or rhythmic patterns, melodic development, or structure between the two tracks. Beyonce won the lawsuit. Later, haters. Speaking of haters, Taylor Swift is used to shaking them off, so it's no surprise she shook off a copyright lawsuit by a musician for $42 million in damages and a songwriting credit. United States District Court Judge Gail Standish threw out the case and even used some of Taylor's lyrics in her statement, saying, quote, "At present, the court is not saying that Jesse can never, ever, ever get his case back in court, but for now, we have got problems and the court is not sure he's solved them." Jesse's lyrics that he felt were similar to Tay's were, quote, Haters gonna hate, players gonna play, watch out for them fakers, they'll fake you every day. And I think we all know how Taylor's song goes. The players gonna play, 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 play. There may be bad blood between T-Swift and the next artist on this list, but they do have one thing in common. They've both been accused of stealing songs. Katy Perry got her start as a Christian artist, but that didn't stop Christian hip-hop group Flame from saying Katy's Dark Horse was a ripoff of their song Joyful Noise. So first, listen to Joyful Noise. Now, listen to Dark Horse. Do they sound similar? I'll let you decide. And finally, Robin Thicke and Pharrell were sued for copyright claim in what ended up breaking the record for the highest payout in a copyright infringement lawsuit in history. The Marvin Gaye estate sued the Blurred Line songwriters and ended up winning $7.3 million in damages. Marvin's family believed, and the court ruled, that Blurred Lines ripped off Marvin's 1977 hit, Got to Give It Up, which goes like this. And in case you forgot, Blurred Lines sounds like this. Pharrell, Robin, and T.I. released a joint statement following the ruling, saying, quote, "While we respect the judicial process, we are extremely disappointed in the ruling made today, which sets a horrible precedent for music and creativity going forward." Janice Gaye, Marvin's former wife, said, quote, "I'm really grateful. I hope people understand that this means Marvin deserves credit for what he did back in 1977. Now, I want to hear your thoughts. Which one of these cases surprised you the most? Let me know in the comments section below, and when you're done with that, you can click right over here for a list of must-hear songs from Ariana's Dangerous Woman, and don't forget to subscribe to Clevver News. Plus, you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at @_TiffanyTaylor. Thanks for hanging out with me right here on Listed. I'm your girl, Tiffany Taylor, and before you go, click to the left for the most heartbreaking songs of 2016 so far, and over to the right for songs written about Taylor Swift.